Hey friends, when you study mathematics, you may face this type of problem. 8 in parentheses, 6 minus 4 minus 3. And look carefully, there is bar on 4 minus 3. That is called as vinculum. Hello friends, welcome to this YouTube channel. And in this video, we are going to understand what is vinculum, its definition, what is its use and many other concepts about vinculum. And we will take some of the examples in order to understand what is vinculum. So let's begin this video. This horizontal line, as you can watching on this top of 4 minus 3, is nothing but vinculum, or also it is called as bar. Friends, this underline is placed generally over the expression. In some cases, very rare cases, this underline is placed below the expressions, but that is very rare. Friends, first we will understand what is the definition of vinculum. Vinculum is nothing but a horizontal line, generally placed over the expression or sometimes below the expression, in order to show that everything that lies below this line is considered under the one group. If someone who don't know this concept of vinculum, he will get confused, and after solving this, he will get his answer as minus 8, and that is wrong answer. The student who has not understand vinculum will solve this problem according to this. He will simply solve this problem 8 in bracket 6. Because he don't understand what is vinculum, he will solve this 4 minus 3 as minus 4 minus 3 is equal to minus 7. Bracket completed. Then after that, simply he will follow the steps in mathematics. 8 in bracket 6 minus 7, that is minus 1. Then 8 into minus 1, that is equal to minus 8. Here he will get minus 8 as his answer. But this method is totally wrong. So let us see the correct method to solve this problem. Then we have to take 8 parentheses 6 minus, then we have understand that anything falls under this vinculum sign comes under one group. So we have to create one separate bracket, that is round bracket, for this step 4 minus 3. The negative sign before 4 minus 3 is not considered in this group. Then we have taken 4 minus 3 in that separate bracket. Then after that, we have to simply solve it as regular we solve this problem. Now we all know that 4 minus 3 will be equal to 1. Then we write 1 in separate round bracket. In the next step after that, we have to minus 1 from 6. We get 5. Then friends, we know that 8 into 5 is equal to 40. We have to write 40. That is actually our correct answer. Hence, in this way, we have get 40 as our answer for this problem. In this way, when you see vinculum sign on your problem, then you have to take separate bracket and then solve this type of problem. If you think about history of vinculum, then you may have wondered that who has introduced this concept of vinculum. Way back in year 1646, the Dutch mathematician Francis van Schooten has introduced this concept. But in modern days, due to the use of brackets, this concept of vinculum is used only to show the repeating decimals. For example, 2.37, and the bar is on 37. That is, the vinculum sign is on 37 only. It means that 2.37, 37, 37, 37, 37, 37, dash 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 up to infinity. This means that the bar is on 37. Hence, after 2.37, 37, 37 is repeating up to infinity. If anywhere while studying maths you find this bar instead on RHS side on LHS side of the decimal point. If this vinculum is on the number which is on left side of the decimal point, then you have to take that number as minus. For example, we take another example, vinculum on 5.069, and we have to write this number as minus 5.069. This is the use of vinculum sign nowadays. That's all in this video, friends. I hope that you understand this concept of vinculum and its uses. Thank you, friends, for watching this video throughout. So we will meet in next video. Oh, 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 oh